Hello YouTube, this is tikibomber here. I'm actually coming through, well, it's the 17th right now, so I kinda had an epiphany. You guys can go ahead and disregard it if you want. This is my theory as to why everything is as insane as it is today. With today, we have a lot of things going on, such as a lot of politics going in place. We have the gender politics, we got the racial politics, we even have the sexual preference politics going into play here. And it all seems like this is everything coming fast at us in one huge whack. And with good reasons. Alright, I saw in my Twitter feed earlier today that Anita Sarkeesian was sitting there talking about how women's rights or gender rights, race and sexual preference is not one thing to tackle at a time, but is in fact a progressive majority that should be tackled all at once. And that everything needs to stop being divided out to deal with one issue at a time. And I would actually agree with that statement, you know? Everything should be handled all at the same time. However, yes, there's a however. There is a system in place as to what gets done first and foremost. And people don't like that because it means that they're being told who's more important than the other when it comes to getting things done. Excuse me. And, you know, they can hate it if they want. I'm not going to be sitting there telling them that they need to stop being so sexist or racist or homophobic or anything like that. Stop being so anti-theist. Stop being so theist. You know, all that other good junk. I could care less. Mainly about all that stuff. But her statement still makes sense to me to a degree. We have a system in place to help us as humans in addressing problems that we should be working on and correcting and fixing. Now, as far as I've seen, history kind of repeats itself, and in more than one way. Even learned history is repeating itself. In history, we learned that men were first, women were second, and then race is third, and finally sexual preference is fourth. You know, with everything else that falls underneath that, like ableism and all that other fun stuff. And what that comes down to is the fact that when it comes to resolving issues and problems as well as concerns, the biggest things that are going to happen first is going to affect men. So, like, the men getting the right to vote, which pissed off the women, because they're told that they could not vote yet. It's not that they couldn't vote, they just couldn't vote yet. Because they were trying to work out a system that allows women to vote as well. Well, women wanted to vote now. And they got their wish. And then a few decades later, the blacks wanted to vote. Again, they were, you know, they were patient, they waited their turn, and they got the right to vote. Well, then we also end up getting things like marriage, how racial marriages should be a thing, because, you know, love is love. And, yeah, that is a phrase I probably will regret saying in the future videos, but you know, love is love. So okay, they finally, you know, the churches mainly were against the racial voting because it devalued their own faith in the segregation and all that other stuff. It also meant that lynch mobs couldn't go and harass random black innocent men and kill them because they were black. Yeah, I'm looking at you, KKK. But you know, the interracial marriage thing became, as it is, a thing. And it's still supported in today's laws and standards. There's no denying that anybody could get married as long as they are of age or permission has been given by the parent or guardian. So, this brings up today, in a long run, the issues that are being addressed. You know, we're trying to tackle everything at the same time in today's society. And it can get very heartening. More so when some of the older things that people stood for, like gender equality, no longer has a relevance place in its hold in today's world. So they make up stuff to be more relevant. Like all these gender identity policies that are now being in place. You know, the Zero Zim type of horseshit. And I don't care what you actually identify gender-wise. I really don't. If I don't know you personally, you are going to be they or them. And that is the actual proper English term to identify a person that you do not know personally as they or them. I don't need a guide on what gender you feel like being today based on the bracelet color that you're wearing. I don't need a book to tell me how to identify somebody's gender when there's like 55 different genders that would qualify as the same one. You know, this is not how society would work in a progressive field. In fact, if anything, that makes it more regressive. Racially, well, I could say we're doing a lot better overall. I mean, lynch mobs have been long since banned, and that's a good thing to have no to no longer be supporting. I do apologize with all the coughing and stuff. You know, lynch mobs have been banned. They're no longer a thing. Black people overall are starting to get into more and more progressive fields. You know, we still have a few people who are going to be racist as ever. Hashtag shut up Tariq being a prominent version for why. Or, no. Shut up Tariq is because he is racist. But again, they're fighting a cause that is literally already been resolved. They want recognition for a lot of things, a lot of things that they themselves didn't even do. And I'm sorry, that's just not how history works. If you really want to push on things like getting recognized in something, in doing something, then push on doing that item. Push on doing that thing. But if you don't, that's fine. If you're just doing it because you want to do it, that's fine. I do support the idea and the fact that more black people are getting out there and doing their thing and getting recognized for more than just music, streetwear, and sitcom television. Like, I do want to see more actors and actresses out there. I do want to see more black people in fields like for science, for technology, for many different things, actually. I want to see more people in general. Not just black people. I want to see more people in general that are United States citizens or people who are not citizens yet work on their citizenship status to become a citizen of the United States. You know? I want to see progression. And with the way things are going, we are not getting progressive, we are getting regressive. I mean, it's right now to the point where black people are saying that white people should be segregated from black people. That's not progression. That is an actual regression sort of deal. If you want to separate yourself from black people or from white people, then that's a you thing. And you, regardless if you want to separate yourself from the other race or not, actually, it doesn't even matter what race. If you want to separate yourself from the race that you deem to be racist, then you yourself are part of the problem. You yourself happen to be racist. The way to end racism is not through segregation. That happened, and it got worse instead of better, where one race was treated better than the other. I don't know why you think segregation would be a better cause for ending racism when it's not. It did not work. I don't know why you guys think it's gonna work today, but you need to get off of that whole segregation board in general. It's not gonna happen. So that leads to the third thing, which would probably be more of a relevant thing if, and this is a big if, there was actual cause for relevance to begin with. And that is sexual preferences. Now, there are some things that would make me go, yeah, no, that's not going to happen in a billion years. That is never going to happen. But for the most part, my stance remains the same. As long as both consenting parties are in fact adults or are mature teenagers, yeah, teenagers, they both have to be teenagers, then I don't care what you guys do in the bedroom. Just don't bring in innocent li don't bring innocent people involved into it. This means absolutely no in a billion years to pedophiles. If you think sleeping with children should be a sexual preference, you're sick and you need to seek help. I know several therapists that would be willing to take on your cases, and they would be willing to help you through this. It is, in fact, a mental disease. Yeah. I can say that homosexuality was deemed as a mental illness too, but that was because of the rapid decline for the Romans' birth rates. And the fact that there was a rapid incline on their death rates. So, they were looking into a solution as to how to fix this. And that solution was to ban all forms of homosexuality. Men and men, women and women, not allowed. In no way, shape, or form was it ever allowed. And yeah, we did have the lesbian porno flicks well beforehand, but overall, you understand the scenario on this. If it was not allowed, then it was not allowed. And because of that, we ended up with, well, we ended up with getting gay pride and all this other stuff popping in. Which, yeah, in today's society, back when it was first being published as well, which was I think in the late 90s, early 2000, gays wanted to get married. My response to that was, fine, let them get married. I don't see a problem with that. In fact, my reason for the gays wanting to get married, promoting them to get married, is the fact that we had, at the time, 6 billion people on the world for the world population, pushing at 7 billion. Now we're 8 billion strong, pushing on to 9 billion. And I still support that. You know, we don't need the rapid birth rates to increase. Unless you're in Japan, then yeah, they do need help. Like, they need big time help. But overall, we do not need a rapid human growth rate anymore. let homosexuality come through. Let them get married. Let them be happy together to be married. And no, homosexuality is not pedophilia. However, there are many cases where pedophilia does come out because of homosexual tendencies. And both cases are not the same, actually. Many cases of pedophilia involves themselves being victims. Many cases of homosexuality involves curiosity and exploring. And teenagers, being themselves, will continue to explore. And that's an okay thing. It's why I'm okay with teenagers, as long as they're teenagers. It is okay. It is why I am okay with transgenders. By the way, transgenderism is not the danger to children learning about sex. It's pedophiles teaching children to consent at an age so young, you're going, what the fuck? You want to know that age? You probably want to know that age. That age happens to be six. Six or even three. I'm saying six because I'm thinking of Sharia law. Their child bride marriage things. But three. Three is a stupid young age to have children be okay and consenting for sex. And I've already stated why that was beforehand. And I'm just like worn out from all the arguing against pedophiles. I'm exhausted in the never-ending battle against social justice warriors finding reasons to stay relevant. I'm sick and tired of all the gender policies that feminism is trying to push. Now, feminism is still itself trying to remain relevant with not just gender policies, but with sexual orientations as well as racial policies. So we get intersectional feminism. Overall, it is a long, tiring battle. One that I want to see ending soon. And I know it's not going to come any sooner, which makes it even more tiresome to deal with. But we got to keep pushing on, just like the rest of the world, because we are still just human beings. We have different ideas, and that's a good thing to have. But overall, when it comes to dealing with our issues, it is a one step at a time progression. You cannot simply have your cake served to you on a silver platter and eat it with a golden fork only because you demand it. You can get your cake. You can get your silver platter. Or you can get your golden fork. Just pick one and stick with it. That aside, I do hope that you guys, especially feminism with the fourth wave and how they're progressing, I really hope you guys keep the fight up against Sharia law. I do hope that we can stop trying to find relevance in something as trivial in today's standards as gender policy, as in racial policy, as in sexual orientation policy. I mean, there are things I think should still be fixed in the world. But the Western world is not the entire world. And I really wish so many people can learn that. They won't. They never will. Because the Western world's the only thing that they've actually ever had in their entire experience. And thus, everything in the Western world is the entire world. And that needs to stop. The United States is not Saudi Arabia. England is not Bangladeshi. France is not Palestine, I'm sorry. You know, Western worlds are not the entire world. Even if it's the only world you know of, it's still not the entire world. Look at the world news in general. Look at news articles from around the world. Translate them. You got Google Translator. See what they say, what's going on in their countries. And then form your own opinion about it. I mean, I feel really bad for a lot of the things that these people go through, such as refugees, real refugees, who are struggling to get to where they're trying to get to and cannot progress very far. Meanwhile, the rich refugees just take advantage of people's kindness and sympathy in our Western societies because they know that they can do it and get away with it. All they have to do is weave some bullshit story about why they're in trouble and wanting to escape. And then it's done. But overall, it's just one long story after another. One long battle after another. And where I'm tired at, I'm still fighting. You know, I'm not giving up. I don't want to give up. I definitely don't want to give up on America. I do understand where everyone is coming from and why they keep fighting the fights that they fight. Why I'm part of the fights that I fight. But there is a point where you literally need to step back. Look at everything around you, not just what's in front of you. And I mean everything around you. And take a deep, long breath. Meditate. Recenter your focus. Recenter your thoughts. Recenter yourself. And just do it. Just from there, focus on what it is that you're trying to achieve. For me, I'm trying to put up all the stop signs and blockades against Sharia law. I've stated in the past videos and given my own straight up opinion about Sharia law. It is not a law for the Western worlds. And feminists like Linda Sussor, I really need to start the hashtag #ShutUpLinda, are muddling what Sharia law really is about. Part of Sharia law is that they will lie to get you to conform to Muslim, to become an Islam. That lying to a non-Muslim is okay as long as you're trying to convert them to Islam. I think that's bullshit. And if you guys know me, I don't like liars. I am pretty certain Jeff Holliday himself would be saying, yeah, this is absolute bullshit. Why the hell are so many of you fuckwits in the Western worlds with the open opinion and ability to disagree with this, choose to agree with it? You know? They use excuses as to why Sharia law would be a better law in the Western world. They use females, women, Muslim women, to sit there and promote how Sharia law is better for the Western society. And the fact that they are Muslim does not instantly deem them to be white, even though people from the Middle East are technically white. You know, they're still seen as a minority, even though they're 1.6 billion strong and growing, with 25% of that 1.6 billion supporting the ISIS terrorist attacks and wants nothing to do to stop them. And to those Muslims who actually do not support the ISIS terrorist attacks, you know, I'm thankful that you don't want to. We are entering a new war, probably even three new wars, as ISIS is looking to expand its borders outside of the Muslim countries, the Islamic states. And that's fine. You know, spread the word of your religion to the people who want to listen to it, to the people who are willing to convert. Telling people that if they do not convert, they will die is not something tolerated by a lot of other individuals. More so in America, where it's actually against the law to tell people such things. So it's why you have the Bible thumpers. They are welcome to talk to you about their religions. You know, it'd be Mormon, which is an American-based religion. It'd be Christianity, Catholicism, baptism, Jewish, or Islam. And then there's many more people outside of that cluster group who are, of course, religious, but not in that sense. Not to mention, I've never been more irritated than I was when I heard that Islam is a religion of peace. When I first heard that, my thought was, no, Buddhism is the religion of peace. But then I remembered Buddhism is not a religion. The guy who started Buddhism did not want to make it into a religion. He wanted to just make a lifestyle, a very peaceful lifestyle, for people looking for peace. But Buddhism has been classified as a religion in several countries. So, unless you can be as peaceful as a Buddhist, and trust me, you can count the number of wars that they've gone through with just one hand. You know, if you want to classify the religion to be as peaceful as Buddhism, then okay. But if you're sitting there telling me that Islam is a religion of peace, as there are Islamic terrorists blowing up countries because there are people who do not believe in Islam, then I'm gonna have to tell you to reevaluate yourself, to get some glasses, because you're clearly blind as a bat, and you're gonna have to learn how to read what peace really means. Because last I checked, and being part of the army myself, peace is when there's no fighting involved. When all sides can come to a small agreement for even a brief moment and not raise a weapon or a hand in combat. That's peace. So, rethink that. If you know what peace is, then cool. If you know what peace is like, awesome. If you think Islam is the religion of peace, not a religion of peace, the religion of peace, then your mind, you've gone through a mind-controlling device, and you need to, like, try and get some help. I'm not saying that Islam is a bad religion. I'm pretty certain there's a lot of things that people can learn for following Islam. You know, it comes with having an open mind in general. But what I do know is that Islam is not a religion, a peaceful religion. And people need to stop saying that it is. But that aside, I'm just... hoping that everything else can come full circle in a good way, not in a bad way. And that we can actually find peace, that we can get help. And yes, that we can stop being so broken in our society that we have to fix things one at a time. Come on. But until that happens, we're still where we're at today. Taking things baby steps. Taking things with a grain of salt. And making sure that everything is being divvied out as much as possible on the equality scale. It can suck in these times, trying to find relevance in what you're fighting for, to the point where you're creating your own relevances to fight for. You know, it's much like what Anita Sarkeesian said, is that all these issues are in fact should be tackled at the same time, but they're tackled individually. And yeah, I do agree with that, but she's also stated that there is breakdowns between all the different issues that need to be addressed. Yes, you know, you're going to have to decide if everything should be tackled at the same time and take longer to resolve, or if everything should be tackled one at a time and take shorter to resolve. In the end, the choice is literally up to us as humans on what should be resolved, what should not be resolved, and how long everything's going to take to get resolved. As humans, we can choose. I mean, I was seriously expecting, instead of a black president, I was expecting a female president. And I was worried too, because Hillary Clinton almost, honestly, Hillary Clinton could have won against Barack Obama if she didn't call him out and called him all these different names like she did. And to be quite fair, that was her fault. She acted like an immature child. She ended up getting the can from the Democratic vote. And then when it came to Bernie Sanders versus Hillary Clinton, she again did the same thing. And the Democratic Party is like, fine, we'll give you